Hello guys, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Today we are going to discuss you about the computer logic training board, that is to understand the arithmetic and logic operation using the 74181 IC, that is ALU chip. So to understand these concepts, we have designed a Tesca's training board which have an order code of 38628. So this is the ALU unit, that is ALU chip of IC 74181. So here on front panel we have given you a IC 74181 diagram. So in IC 74181 we have an input section, that is A0, A1, A2, A3, that is 4 bit input A. Similarly we have a B0, B1, B2, B3, 4 bit input B, and we have also provided you carry input to generate the carry. Similarly we have an output F0, F1, F2, F3. So F0 is the output corresponding to A0 and B0. F1 is the output corresponding to A1, B1. Similarly, F2 is for A2, B2, and F3 is for A3 and B3. So these are the output. We have also provided you carry output. So whenever there is a carry, this LED will glow. Whenever there is no carry, this LED will low. And we have also provided you equality output, that is to compare the two inputs A and B. If A equals to B, this LED will glow. This is the logic state indicator, which indicates that logic high or low. So, and the most important part of this experiment is the selection line and mode control. So using selection line, we are going to control the input. For example, we have to give some select lines, for example 0000. On this 0000, we select the input and we perform the different operation. So using this ALU, we are going to learn about the arithmetic and logic operations. So arithmetic operations are A plus B, A minus B, whereas logic operations are AND, OR, NOR. These are the XOR, these are the logic operation. So this is the ALU unit. So to understand different operation, we have given you a manual. So using this manual, we are going to verify the truth table of 74181 ALU. So I am starting with the M equals to 1 and CN bar equals to cross, means don't care. You give any input to CN bar, there is a no problem due to the CN bar. So I am starting with the first line, that is 0000. So on 000 selection line and on mode equals to 1 and CN bar equals to don't care, we have a output of, we have a NOT gate operation. So to understand this logic operation of NOT gate, we have to turn on the training kit. So here we have a, I have already told you that for A0, F0 is the output, and for B0, F0 is the output. So here I have given the A0 input 0. So A0 input 0 means 0. And where is in output we are getting the complicated output. So for 0 we are getting a 1, for 1 we are getting the 0. So you can see here on the F0. Similarly if I give to A1, so here I have given the A1 1. So on A1 we have a F1, that is output 0. So this is the NOT gate logic operation. Now on M equals to 1, we have performed the operation. Here you can see again, for 1 logic output 0, for 0 logic output 1. Similarly for logic 1 output 0, for A1 1 output F1 0, for A1 0 output F1 1. So this is the operation of NOT gate. Now when the select line are 0001, we are going to see the logic operation of NOR gate. To understand the NOR gate, we have to give the mode value equals to 1 and Cn bar an input. So 2, where S3 is 0, S2 is 0, S1 is 0, and where S0 is 1. Now on this select lines, we are going to see the logic operation of NOR gate. So here I have provided the A0 0 and B0 0. It means 0 or 0. 0 or 0 means 0, and the complement of 0 is the 1. So you can see here F0 is 1. So this is the operation of NOR gate. Similarly, for example, I am giving the A0 1, B0 1, means 1 or 1, the OR of 1 and 1 is 1, and the complement of 1 is 0. So you can see here F0 is 0. Similarly, for 1, for A0 1, B0 0, means 1 or 0 means 1, and the complement of 1 is 0. So this is the operation of NOR gate. Similarly, if I change the input, for example, I am taking the input A1, means A1 1 and B1 1. So 1 OR of 1 and 1 are 1, and the complement is, its complement is 0. So you can see corresponding A1 and B1, we have output F1. So here it is low. For 0 0, for A1 0, B1 0, so corresponding output is 1. So this is the means 0 and 0, OR of 0 and 0 are 0, and complement of this 0 0 are 1. So here F1 is glowing. So this is the logic operation of NOR gate. Now we are taking the select lines 0 0 1 0. Now on this select lines, the output is A complement dot B. So to understand this logic operation, first of all, make the S3 0, S2 0, S1 1 and S0 0. So I have made the select line as per in the manual. Now F equals to A bar B is the output for this select lines. So now I am giving the A0 input 0 and B0 input 1. So the output is A bar B. It means here A equals to 0, means A bar is the 1, means complement of 0 is 1, whereas B0 is the 1, means the end of 1 and 1 is now 1. So you can see here corresponding to A0, B0, the output is 1. So this is the A bar B operation. Similarly, here I am taking the A1 and B1, corresponding to this A1, B1 input, we are going to see, observe the output F1. So here I am taking the A1, 1, and B1, 1. Now the output is A1 bar dot B1. So A1 bar is the 0 and B1 is the 1. So 0 dot 1 means 0. So you can see here F1 is 0. So this is the logic operation on the select lines 0 0 1 0, is F equals to A complement B. Now we are moving on our next select lines, that is 0 0 1 1. So now on these select lines, we are going to see output 0. So F equals to 0 means no one LED is glowing in this output, means F0, F1, F2, F3 will become 0. So for 0 0 1 0 0 1 1, so now you give any input, the output is always 0. So you can see here F0, F1, F2, F3 is 0 everywhere. So on any input, if you want to give but the select lines are 0, 0, 1, 1, it means the output should be 0. So this is all about this logic operation. Now on select lines, on different select lines, that is 0, 1, 0, 0, we are going to see the logic operation of NAND gate. So to understand the logic operation of NAND gate, first of all, make the select lines as per the manual, means S3 0, here S3 already 0, S2 1, here S2 1, and S1, S0 are 0, 0. Now, we are going to perform the operation of NAND gate. So NAND gate is the complement of AND gate. So corresponding to A0, B0, we are going to see the output F0. So here 1 means A0 1 and B0 1. The AND of A0 and B0 are 1, and the complement means NAND gate is the output is 0. So this is the logic operation NAND gate. Similarly, here I am giving A0 0 and A1 0 and B1 0. So AND of 0 0 0 and the complement of 0 is 1. So here you can see on the F1 we have output 1. So this is all about the logic operation of NAND gate. Now we are moving on our next select lines, that is 0 1 0 1. So on this 0 1 0 1 we are going to see the NOT gate of input B. So to see this output, first of all, make the select lines as per the manual. So 0 1 0 1. Now if I give the input B, I am going to see the output complemented. So for B0, corresponding output F0, for B1 F1, for B2 F2, for B3 F3. So here I am giving the B0 1 So here I am giving the input B0, in output I am get the NOT gate of B0, means complemented of B0. Here I have given the B0 logic high, in output I am getting the logic low. Similarly, here I am giving the input logic low, the output is logic high. For this B1, I am giving the B1 input high, in output F1 is low. So this is the operation of complemented of B. So this is all about this logic operation. Now we are going to see the next select lines, that is 0 1 1 0. On this logic operations, sorry, on this select lines, we are going to perform the logic operation of XOR gate. So you know that XOR always makes the out, XOR is the OR detector, means for 1 XOR 0, the output is 1. For 1 XOR 1, the output is 0. So to understand the XOR gate, first of all, make the select lines S3 is 0. So here S3 is 0. S1, 1. S2, 1. And S0, 0. Now, here I have given the A0 1 and B0 0, and I have told you the XOR is the OR detector, means the output is high for dissimilar input and whereas output low for the similar input. So here A0 1 and B0 0 means 1 XOR 0 is 1. So you can observe on F0 we have a XOR gate output. Similarly, for 1 XOR 1, the output of XOR gate is 0. So here 1 XOR 1, the output is 0. Similarly, here A1 1, B1 1. Here A1 XOR B1 means 1 XOR 1, the output is 0. So you can see the output F1 corresponding to A1 B1. Similarly, you can perform the B2 A2, B3 A3. This is all about the logic operation of XOR gate. Now we are going to see the next logic operation of XNOR gate. So XNOR always detect the similar input and it gives the output 1. For dissimilar input, it will give the output 0. So to understand the XNOR gate, I have to give the select lines S3 1. So here S3 1, S2 0, S1 0 and S0 1. So now by using this select lines, we are going to perform the logic operation of XNOR gate. So for A01, B01, the XNOR will detect the similar input. So output is 1. For 0, for 0, for A00, B00, again the XNOR will detect the similar input. But if B01, A00, the XNOR does not detect the dissimilar input, means F0 is 0. So this is all about the logic operation of XNOR gate. Now we are going to see the logic operation of AND gate. So to understand the logic operation of AND gate, we have to give the select lines S3 1, S2 0, S1 1 and S0 1. So here S3 1, S2 0, S1 1 and S0 1. Now for AND gate A0 B0, if A0 B0 is 1 1, the output is 1. Here the output is 1. For 0 0, the output is 0. For 1 0, the output is 0. So this is all about the AND logic operation. Now we are going to see the logic operation in which the output is F equals to 1, means all LED will glow in this output. So for this output, we have to select the select lines S3 1, S2 1, S1 0 and S0 0. So here I am taking S0 0, S1 0, S2 1 and S1 1. So you can see F equals to 1 means all LED will glow in this combination of select lines. Now we are going to see the combination for OR gate to perform the logic operation of OR gate. So to understand the OR gate operation, we have to give the S3 1, S2 1, S1 1, S0 0. So here S0 is 0, S1 1, S2 1 and S3 1. Now OR gate means 1 or 1, 1, 1 or 0, 0, sorry, 1 or 0, 1, 0 or 0, 0. So to understand this operation, here I am giving the A0 1 and B0 0, means 1 or 0 output is 1. For 0 or 0, the output is 0. This is all about the logic operation of OR gate. Now we are going to perform the logic operation in which the output is always A. If I give the input A, the output will result A. So to understand this operation, I have to give the select all select lines at 1 1 1 1. So here S0 1, S2 1, 1 1, all are 1 1. Now if I am giving A0 1, the output is 1. For A1 1, 1 1. So you can see on this select lines we can perform the operation of buffer. So this is all about the logic operation. Now we are going to understand the arithmetic operation using ALU chip. So to understand the arithmetic operation, means plus and minus, I have to make the M equals to 0, CN bar equals to 1, means this is the low active carry, means no carry. At CN bar equals to 1, it means we have to don't give any carry. So this is our training board. So on this training board, we are going to perform the arithmetic operation. So this is very beautiful operation using this ALU chip. So first of all, make the M equals to 0. Here mode control switch is on 0 position now. Okay, now give the carry input 1. So here I am performing this A plus B operation, means if I am giving the A input, for example 4, and B input, for example 4, so in output we are getting a 8 in the 8421 code. So this is the addition concept. So to understand the A plus B output, we have to make the select lines S3 1, S2 0, S1 0 and S0 1. So here S3 is 1, S2 is 0, S1 is 0 and SW1 is, means S0 is 1. Now, so you have to understand this code as per I'm telling you that here A3 means 8, A2 means 4, A1 means 2 and A0 means 1, means 8421 code. Similarly, B3, B2, B1, B0 corresponding to 8421 code. So on output, similarly we have 8421 corresponding code. So here I am giving the A01 means A01s and A21. So this is the binary number, that is 0101, means I have given the input 5. You can see here I have given the input 5. Similarly, I am giving the B01. This is 0, this is 0 and this is 0, means I have given the input in decimal 1. Means if I add the two numbers 5 plus 1, the output is 6. So it is the addition operation. So in output I am getting the 6. So this is the binary number 8421. So it means this is the output is 6, means F1 F2 is glowing, means 4 and 2 code are active. If I add these 2 bit as 4 plus 2, the output is 6. So you can see here output is 6 in the decimal numbers. Similarly, if I am giving the decimal number 3, so here I am giving the 3, means A3 at 0 position, A2 at 0 position and A1 and A0 are on 11 position, means I have given the decimal number 3 and on this I have given the decimal number 1. So 3 plus 1 means 4 is the output. So here in output we are getting the 4. So this is the plus operation, means arithmetic operation using the ALU 74181 chip. Now we are going to see the arithmetic operation minus. So to understand this operation, I have to make the select lines. Here I am performing this result A minus 1. So to understand this operation, I have to make the select lines 1, 1, 1, 1. So here I have given all the select lines at 1, logic 1, 1, 1. Now I am giving the A0, 1, A1, 1, A2, 0, A3, 0. Means I have given the input A in decimal, that is 3 number, means the decimal number is 3, and in input B I have given the B01 and all B1, B3, B2 are at 0 position. It means I have given the decimal number 1. Now if I subtract 2 numbers, means sorry, only we are talking about the A input A. So I have given the input A at decimal number 3. So in output we are getting the result decreased by 1. If I am giving the input 3, the output is 2. It means A minus 1. So here in output we are getting the 2. It means it is decreased by 1. Similarly, here I am giving the input 7. So in output we are getting 6. Means 1 number is decreased. So here in output, decrement of 1 number. Input 7, the output is 6. For input 5, the output is 4. So you can see it is performing the minus operation, means A minus 1. So this is the arithmetic operation. So similarly, using this truth table, you can perform other arithmetic operations. So we have provided in the manual. Now I am going to perform the same operation using let us say we can also perform this operation a plus a. So for performing this operation a plus a, now we are adding the same input. So to understand this operation, make the select lines S3 1, S2 1, S1 0 and S0 0. So here S3 is 1, S2 1, S1 0 and S0 0. Now here the input is 5. So input is 5, the output should be 10, because we are adding the A plus, same number means A plus A. So output should be 10. So you can see in output, the output is 10 if you compare with the 8421 code. So this is all about this arithmetic operation using no carry. Now we are go with the with carry. Now we are going to perform the arithmetic operation with carry. So first of all, I am going to perform the first operation, that is a plus 1. So to understand this operation, we have to make the select lines 0 0 0 0. So here on training board, I have made all select lines at 0 position. Now I have to give the carry. So to give the, so I have already told you that this is a, it is a active low carry. So on 0 it will get activated. Now on this select line combination, that is 0 0 0 0, we are going to perform the operation a plus 1. So here in input, I have given the input in decimal number is 1. So here I have given the input a is 1. So in output it should be 1 plus 1 means 2. So it will perform the a plus 1 operation. So in output I am getting the 2. Similarly, if I am giving the input 3, the output should be 4. So in output we are getting the 4. Similarly, for the input 7, we are getting the output 8. So you can perform the same with different input combination. Now I am going to perform the next operation with carry, that is f equals to 0. So to get this result, I have to make the select lines S3, S2, 0, 0, S3, S2, 0, 0, and S1 and S0 should be 1, 1. So you can see in output, I am getting F equals to 0. So you give any input, the output is always 0. So this is all about this operation. Now we are moving the next operation, arithmetic operation, that is a minus b. So to understand this operation, I have to select the select lines 0, 1, 1, 0. So S0, 0, S1, 1, S2, 1 and S3, 0. Now here I am giving the So now we are going to see the operation a minus b. So here I have given the input a 2. So you can see here, 3. Here I have given the input 3. Input a is 3 and input b is 0. So 3 minus 0 means 3. So in output we are getting the 3. Similarly, if I am giving the input a is 3 and input b is 1. So in output should be 2. So in output we are getting that 2. So this is all about this minus arithmetic operation. Now we are moving on our next operation, that is a plus a plus 1. To understand this operation, I have to make the S3 1 S2 1 S3 1 S2 1 and S1 and S0 at 0 0 position. Now I am giving the in output we are getting the a plus 1, means the addition of two numbers is increased by 1. So here I am giving the input 3, means 3 plus 3 6 and plus 1 7. So in output we are getting the 7. Similarly, if I am giving the input 1, the output should be 3. So in output we are getting the 3. So this is all about this a plus one operation. So similarly, using this video or using this manual, you can perform all other logic and arithmetic operation. You can also compare the two bits, means bit A, for example, A is 1, B is 1. So this A equals to B means equality output LED will glow. So this will give you the equality output. So similarly, you can perform all the experiment using our manual and using our training board, and you can also go with this video. So there are different operations, logical operations, arithmetic operation, addition, subtraction, increment a number by one, decrement a number by one. So I have told you all the operations in this table and in this video. So this is all about this video. You can go with this video to understand about the 74181 ALU chip. So thank you for watching this video. For other queries, you can contact Tesca Technologies Private Limited, and you can also go with this manual. Thank you.